We'd like to get ready to roll the floor over to Tolelo, our Swinomish! Swinomish! Tolelo song hit! Oh, Swinomish! Our great hosts from last year, Seattle, they set the bar very high. We hope we're meeting that standard that Swinomish put out last year. We want to thank you again for being here in Squaxin Island. Swinomish, the floor is yours, Seattle. Tolelo, you're on deck. Thank you.
like to thank you all for being here today on behalf of our tribe. We paddled here today in 4 canoes. It's the first time our family's come down in 4 canoes, so we wanted to. That song, we were trying to bring out all 4 names of our canoes, is recognizing all our pullers and recognize the spirit of the canoe. The canoe took care of us on the way down here. The canoe has a life of its own. Every one of these paddlers, every one of member of our family, they learn those teachings each and every time we get in the canoe, each and every time we circle up, each and every time we gather, each landing that we come to, each protocol that we participate in, there's a teaching there. There's a lesson to be learned. We recognize each other's homes. We recognize each other's homelands. We come and visit you. You come and visit us. We had our paddle the Swinomish last year in 2011. This is the result we have, a resurgence of culture. We had a handful of songs that we shared each and every year. Now we have over 30 that we can bring out here and share with our family, share with our hosts. And each song has purpose and meaning. Each song, it brings out that spirit in all of us. So we just wanted to share that here today. Our kids want to show their appreciation with their dance. You know, we travel in so many aspects of our life. We travel to each other's homes. As it was said before, this could be shared as a longhouse. We bring our elders to guide us and protect us. They walk in before us, and those teachings are passed on. We teach each other how to respect one another, how to respect each other's homelands. But every once in a while, our younger ones can stray off. So if our younger ones have been misbehaving in any way, representing the way they're not supposed to, we just want to apologize for that. But we also want to show our respect. Raise our hands to each and every one of you for inviting us down here and taking that time to bring your people together. So we have, just to explain that entry, we have 4 family canoes, and this is new for us. We're really proud of our youth for coming forward and filling up those seats and those canoes. Really proud of our pullers and the ones that are traveling, our grounds crew. So we just wanted to introduce our chairman, Speepots, Brian Cladsby, to come up and share a few words here. Yes.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Canoe Journey family. Hey, Andy, you got an extra banana? You know, it's a real honor to be on this sacred floor with my family behind me here. It's a real honor to be in the homeland of the mighty Squaxin Island Nation. I'm very proud of your accomplishments. the things that you have done the last 20 years to become the number one employer in Mason County. Nobody else in Mason County puts more people to work than you guys. That needs to be brought out. That's a great accomplishment. You guys should be proud of what you do for your people, not only your people, but the people that live in your communities. And I know the majority of your employees like us are non-Indian. We just need to bring that out and thank you. We thank you for allowing us to come into your homeland for this canoe journey. We traveled from Swinomish. We know what it's like to put on a canoe journey. Swinomish 2011, and I'm proud of the council members for being here. I know that some crazy tribal leader put out a challenge last year. And let's give these council members a big round of applause. I don't know what many of you are doing at 4:30 this morning, but Chairman Lopeman was just going to bed. Dave, thank you. Thank you. You know, this is a sacred place that we're in today. Many of us use this journey for healing. Many of us come from communities where we have family members that are still struggling with drugs and alcohol. And I thank our Creator for those that have chosen to give up the drugs and alcohol. It's important that I recognize each and every one of you. You are role models in our community and for our children. I want to recognize you. I want you to stand up to show that Indian Country is clean and sober. Those that are walking that red road, let us recognize you right now. Please stand up. You are our role models. To our parents that stood up, that are raising your children in a drug and alcohol-free home for the first time in generations, our hands go up to you parents that are letting your kids know that you can be raised in a home where there's no drugs and no alcohol. And to you parents, God bless you parents. God bless you. It's an honor to be here at Squaxin Island, representing my people, standing with my elders, my other council members, my vice chair, Talak Tala. Is she here, out here yet? She's waiting for, where's Talak Tala? Thank you, Talak Tala. Sapilia, another council member. Yaqualus, another council member. Smakala. Walechib, my council members would come up here. These are our elected leaders at Swinomish, and I'm very proud of their commitment that they've made to our culture to come and stand with their children, their grandchildren, and the Pullers to let them know that we are there with them and for them. At one point, we've had 5 council members on our canoe traveling down here, and I want to thank them for that commitment that they've made, that commitment and that sacrifice. We now have 4 canoes traveling the sacred waters, the Salish Sea. 3 years ago, we were about 10% of what you see right here. And Eric Day and his crew there for many years was holding up that candle for Swinomish. And he dreamt of this day when he'd have this type of participation. And Eric, I want to thank you and your crew for all those that pulled on the Squaliatute all those years to, you know, keep that flame alive for Swinomish. All right, we have 4 canoes represented here. We're going to go for about 6, 7, 8 hours. 8:05. Andy last night asked if we could do that, so yeah, right. Now we have a handful of songs here we want to share with you, some dances, and on behalf of the Swinomish Tribe, Squaxin Island, we raise our hands up to you for hosting, and yes, Andy, we do have a challenge dance for you later. All right, let's start to roll, Swinomish.
The first song we're going to sing is our healing song. And this song is going out to anybody who needs prayer. This song is dedicated to our Squaxin Island family for hosting us here. This is a blessing song. So our kids are going to come around with a prayer in their heart for everybody who needs prayer today, for our elders, for the addicted, for anybody who couldn't be here with us. This song is our healing song. This is our Spirit of the Eagle song. Next up, we have our warrior song, and this is dedicated to all our veterans.
At this time, if we could have all of our warriors, our veterans, please stand and be recognized. Raise your hands, tip your hats. Warriors, veterans, where are you at? Raise your hand, keep them up high. Keep them up high, veterans! We thank you for your service, your sacrifice. This song is dedicated to the ones we love. Our veterans, our warriors. Give it up once again for our warriors, please.
Thank you to all our veterans. Thank you for your service. The next song we're going to sing for you is our Good Morning song. This is our Eagle Blessing song. Ladies, if you'd like to come down and join our girls, please do so. Please come join us for the Eagle Blessing. Thank you. let's give everybody a big hand. Thank you for joining us. Next up, we have Wapio's Warrior Song.
Wow, Andy Whitener. Yeah. Where's my cousin Ray at? Right there, man. Give it up for those two young men. Way to go. Andy, I tried to push Leon out there to join you. Thought he was your brother, man. I thought so too. All right, Wapio.
The next song we're going to share with you is Clearing the Path.
Thank you.
Sea Serpent song is next. This next song we're going to share with you is our friendship love song. So at this time, I'm going to ask our kids to go and grab somebody from the audience to come and dance with them. If they pick you, you can't say no. We also shared this song with our Warm Springs family. So if any of our Warm Springs family is here, please come forward and join us. Make it quick, kids. Choose somebody quickly, please. You can't say no, Randy.
Oh,
Now this is our love song. Thank you. Give them a big round of applause. Good job. Thank everybody for coming out. That's what Journey's all about, friends and family, loving, caring, and sharing together. Hustle up, girls. The next song we're going to share with you is Natasha's Paddle Song. Oh,
OCM. OCM. And for my Canadian brothers and sisters, ACM. Come on, you guys are awake, come on. Well, that was hour number one in the books. We got three more hours. That was 12 songs. Since we hosted last year, we know how important it is to try to stay on schedule and keep the program going. So we shared 12 songs with our canoe family here, and we figured that's good enough. We want to help you guys out. We have about 20 more songs that we'd like to bring out, but at another time. Oh, what'd you say, Andy? Keep going. We greatly, greatly, greatly appreciate the Creator giving us traveling mercies on the Salish Sea, coming down here to Squaxin Island. I've got great, great brothers and sisters down here. We're very, very close. Just to share a story with you, a true story. Back in the late 1800s, the BIA wanted to terminate two tribes. Guess which two? Squaxin Island and Swinomish. It was because of some whiteners and Peters and Cladis Bees and but they wanted to move Swinomish to Lummi. Any Lummies in the house? And they wanted to move Squaxin to Puyallup. Any Puyallups in the house? They saved you guys. But once again, it's a really honor to be on your floor, to be in your homelands, to share songs with you and dances. And at this time, we have some gifts that we'd like to bestow upon each and every one of you here. And can we get all the council members to line up, please? We're going to do a push-up contest. Push-ups. Come on, Andy, get up. Come on out, council members. We just want to recognize you. Yeah. No, Andy, not those kind of push-ups. Okay, we have Chairman Dave Lopeman. Island Tribes, yeah. And we have these hats also here for you. The rest of you, please. Please remove your hats. We have hats that we'd like to... Yeah. Yeah, we live on an island. You live on an island. Hey, and do we have any other Swinomish members in the crowd that would please come and join us as we do this? I see some Swinomish. Anybody that's married to a Swinomish? Anybody that wants to be Swinomish? Anybody that wants to marry a Swinomish? Hey, those young ladies over here gave us the biggest yell when I said that. So I want all of our Swinomish members coming down here to... We're going to do our departure song after we do our gifts, and we want all of our Swinomish members to come up with us and to walk out with us. Please, if you're in the crowd, if you have kids that are Swinomish, if you have moms and dads that were Swinomish, grandparents that were Swinomish, and once again, to our Canoe Journey family, our hands go up to each and every one of you for your patience, for sitting here and enjoying the songs and the dances, and just being respectful. Seahawk? Is that a Seahawk hat? Wow. Jim, I hope you're a Seahawk fan. Oh, yeah. That's pretty good. Many of you have seen these coats that the Swinomish family has been wearing throughout the journey here, and we'd also like to make you honorary Swinomish canoe family members. So we want to see you on one of the four canoes next year. Skipper, you already got your Gilligan behind me. Yeah, you guys can mix and match the sizes there. Yeah, XL, 2X, 3X. We got any more Swinomish out there? Come on up here, Sepelia. Help the girls. Oh, there's Tala Tala. Thank you, thank you. If the council could help us pick out a couple elders to come forward. If the council could recognize a couple elders, help us out here, we'd really appreciate it. And also a couple youth of Squaxin Island. No, Andy, not you. Sit down. A couple elders and a couple youth, please. The two youth, right out here, please. Two youth, right out there, please. Two youth. One more youth, one more. Okay. All righty, these kids are gonna grow into these coats. All right. Woo! Two more honorary Swinomish canoe family. We also have a couple paddles for these young ones here. All right. Take a picture right there. Hey, boys, take a picture. Right there. There you go. Got an elder over here.
My name's Arnold, and I'm the vice chairman of the Squaxin Island Tribe. We wanted to bring up our eldest elders that are, you know, wheelchair bound, but they are very respected in our tribe. So I want to give a big hand and hands up in the air for both of them. Thank you.
Do we have someone from Nisqually here? Jerry is the head cook from Nisqually. Is Jerry here? I mean, Nisqually has been awesome. We've been intentionally camping right next to their cook place. We don't want too many people to know about this. But Nisqually has really stepped up to the plate for us, and we want to recognize you and Nisqually, and we look forward to Nisqually 2016! All right. right, get ready, Nisqually. We're coming in. What year is this? In 4 years, huh? From Squaxin Island, we have Jeremiah, Deborah, and Terry. Are they here? Jeremiah, Deborah, and Terry? Are they here, council members? Terry's here. And if we could have someone stand in for Jeremiah and Deborah. Jeremiah. Just come on out here, please. Jeremiah's mom. Okay, witnesses, keep an eye on Andy. Yeah, it don't mean nothing. And these were your main coordinators for putting this together this year. Oh, no, Andy, not you. Give him a hand. All right, we have a couple short songs in the departure song.
I just want to say real quick, remember last time we were in this on these shores here in 2007, that was actually the beginning of our hosting for 2011. We started right here, and that led to us getting to the year 2011. I just wanted to say that real quick, the hospitality that's been shown here by the Squaxin Island people, hands go up to you. All the hard work you guys done, the dedication you've done. And on behalf of the Squaxin Tut at Sea Salad, I'd like to ask permission to untie our canoe so we can journey home. Osio.
Swinomish people, we know how strong you are in your traditions and how strong you are spiritually. Before I grant you the ability to leave our shore, there's one thing that's got to be taken care of. And I need your chairman to come out, because I know you're a strong people. And last year, he challenged me to do 50 push-ups in front of everybody. At that time. At that time, I was recovering from hip surgery. So he let me off easy. I did 30. So he owes me 30 push-ups. So if we could have people count out. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Give them a hand. 53 for a 53-year-old man. Yeah. 53 years young. Brian and I are good friends. We talk about the importance of being strong spiritually, mentally, and physically. And you can't have a better role model than your chairman. And Mel Sheldon will be out here next doing push-ups. Thank you for sharing your songs, your dance, your drums. Thank you. It's our honor to have you as our guest this past week. We hope that you can stay around for the last couple days. You have permission to leave our shores.
Once again, to our Squaxin people here, I want to thank you for the invitation. Thank you for inviting us to your home. You know, this is the first time I went on a journey. I usually stay home and race canoes, but our chairman here has been trying to get me on the journey canoe for almost 5 years. And so I joined him halfway down from Swinomish, and it's been an honor. It's a life's lessons to be learned. You look at those experiences in a different way. Each and every one of us have our own experience. Each and every one of us went through this in a different way, but we all did it together. So we just wanted to thank you for opening those doors. Thank you for guiding us through your waters. And thank you for having this gathering of nations, gathering of people that want to come together. So on behalf of the Zubala Tisalat, we'd like to ask permission to untie our canoe and leave your shores. Peace.
No more push-ups? Okay, fine. I do want to make one statement. I appreciate your guys' fellowship and your friendship that we have throughout the years. It's great when Brian shaves a couple strokes off the beat me on the golf course, but that's a different story. They also requested firewood in their campground, so we provided that for them as well. And but again, your fellowship and friendship, and it's so welcome here on our shores, and you have our permission to leave.
My name is Bonnie Fornsby, and I'm the skipper of the Swaltzalita. We've had a really good journey down here, and we thank you guys for your hospitality. We are asking permission to untie our canoe and leave your shores. Osiam.
On behalf of the Squaxin Island tribe, we enjoyed your company. I also enjoyed the historical landing site that you guys landed on our Squaxin Island. Squaxin Island is really cultural to our people. That's where our ancestors are. So being on that island with our ancestors, you lifted them up. You were out there with them, and they were out there with you, watching you and protecting and watching everything that you do. So I think there was good medicine that was taken to the island that belongs to the Squaxin Island people. So with that, I thank you for all your songs and your dances and having such a good company with us, and give you permission to leave.
Okay.
My name is Tawashtawab, my ancestral name. My given name is JoJo Peters. And this year, I've been honored and humbled to skipper our new youth canoe, Miamont Salad. And I think at this time, I want to recognize the youth that have paddled from home, from Lacona, from Swinomish, down here to your guys' territory, to Squaxin. So can I have the youth raise their hands that were on the canoe? A lot of, for the youth, it's been their first time on the journeys and the first time paddling. So I'm really proud of them. And I can't express on how much, you know, that's made me feel that they've taught me, not me teaching them, but they've taught me. But I'd like to thank you guys for hosting us, and with the great food that you guys had and all the seafood. Why would I like to ask permission to untie your canoe from your shores?
Swinomish people, we enjoyed your stay here, and on behalf of the Squaxin Island tribe, people of the water, I just wanted to comment that you guys are a strong nation, and I've worked with many of your people, and we're working together again on our health of our people and getting our fish healthier so that cleanse our bodies. And we're battling with a force to bring our fish consumption rate here in Washington up to a healthy level for all of us, not just our tribal people, but for all of our neighbors that are out there that eats that great food. And it's been an honor working with you for many, many years in protecting our natural resources. And at this time, I grant you permission to leave shores. Thank you very much for your visit.
We have a few more songs to share with you, and this song that we're going to sing is dedicated to my late brother, and my hands go up to Swinomish family because they always practice loving, caring, and sharing with one another. So this song is in remembrance of my brother, Haishkasiam.
Ooh.
Kaishkasiam. At this time, we'll share another paddle song with you. This is Stoney's paddle song.
Oh,
OCM, thank you. The next song that we're gonna sing for you is the Sea Wolf song, and this is dedicated to Swatzalitza, our Swatzalitza canoe family. Once again, our hands go up to our family here in Squaxin Island. Thank you for such a memorable experience. This is a journey that Swinomish will cherish for years and years to come. Your hospitality here has been remarkable and amazing. And I have to tell you that the time that we've spent here has uplifted all of us from Swinomish. We've been uplifted by this experience and we're so grateful. We cannot ever put a price on what we've received here. Our hands go up to you. Thank you so much. And with that, we're going to share our departure song with you. Once again, thank you so very much from the bottom of our hearts.
If I could have our elders come up front, please, lead us around. Our elders, come up here, please. You girls are still going to dance. Come on up, elders. Swinomish elders. Any more elders back there? Any more elders? Come forward, please. Yes, two more years. I mean, I got training wheels on. Once again, Squaxin Island Council, we raise our hands to you for the great potlatch that you put on for the Coast Salish people. You did a magnificent job. You set the bar high, but you know what? There's going to be another great one next year in Quinault. Right, Quinault?
Swinomish! Oh, CM, give it up for Swinomish again, 2012. Journey to Squaxin Island. My relatives, our family there was looking for a lost little girl during their whole performance, and as soon as the little girl heard them get off the floor, she was running back. But my relatives, again, on behalf of our tribal council, our canoe committee, our elders, and our children, we want to thank you for your presence here at Squaxin Island, for being here and making our potlatch your potlatch and dressing our floor. Again, my relatives.